Hi, my name is Emily, and in this series of videos, I'll be walking you through the concept of dynamic memory allocation. So in this video, I'll tell you why you need dynamic memory allocation and the different uses that you can use it for. In my next video, I'll walk you through in more detail the entire dynamic memory allocation process, and in Callum's videos, he'll teach you how to implement it all in C. So at this point in your coding career, you've learned a lot of concepts, you know how to write while loops, how to make functions, and you can make some pretty useful programs. However, there are still some problems that you can't solve yet with your skill set. One of them would be this. So suppose I want you to make a program that asks the user to enter a size, and then you have to make an array of that size that the user inputted. So if you're starting to write your program, you probably write something like int size, so you have a variable to store the size that the user inputs. You prompt the user for that size. And then you use scanf to read it in. Use %d because that's the format specifier for integers. And make sure you give scanf the address to size so it can change the value. And now you want to clear your array, and you'll probably say, okay, I want an integer array of size. I'll call it nums, so I have an int. I want to call my array nums, and the size will be size. However, you'll have to believe me when I say that this will not work in older versions of C. And the reason behind that requires you to understand the process of coding. So when we code and we make a program, we run a program, there are three basic phases. The first is coding. And that's what we did here. This lives in your .c file, maybe something like hello.c. And we write down all of our instructions in C for running our program and what we need to do. That's all fine and good. After that, we enter compile time. This is where you take your .c program, you run it through your compiler called DCC, and it creates an executable for you. So during that compilation process, what DCC does is it goes into memory. So this is the memory of your computer, and it looks at your code and it allocates space for all of the variables that you've declared. So once it gets to here, it'll say, okay, you wanted an integer variable called size, that's fine. I'll allocate some space for you for one integer. Then it gets to here and it says, all right, you want an array called nums of size, but how big is size? We don't actually have a value for this variable until our third phase, which is called runtime. So this is when we actually run our hello program using the .hello command. So only then can the user enter in an input for size, and then you have an actual number for how large you want your nums array to be. So once the compiler gets to here, it'll get stuck because it doesn't actually know how many bytes to allocate to this nums variable. So to solve this, we have dynamic memory allocation. And what this does is it allows you to manage memory during runtime. And that's the important part. Usually with our compiler like DCC, it sets out all the memory that you need, but that's during compile time. It cannot account for things that will only be initialized during runtime. That's when you need dynamic memory allocation. So if you actually go home and try out this program, you might notice that, hey, my computer says that it runs fine and program works fine without using dynamic memory allocation. What's going on? So this won't work in older versions of C, but in newer versions of C that you probably have on your computer, there is support for something called variable size arrays. So what a variable sized array is, instead of having your arrays declared, like I want an integer array called nums of size 4096. That's an actual number. It's a concrete number. When the compiler goes into your program and tries to allocate memory, it knows that you want 4096 integers. That's all fine and good. But with variable size arrays, you're actually allowed to specify your size as the variable as long as when your program is running and it gets to this part in the program, this size is initialized. So that will work, but understanding dynamic memory allocation helps you understand the whole process of why variable size arrays can exist. Another great use of it, though, is that dynamic memory allocation allows you to create variables that exist outside of the function that created it. So usually when we have a function, remember we have a function and it has its own local variables, but once the function exits, all those variables disappear. That's not the case with dynamic memory allocation because it doesn't allocate memory in the usual place. It allocates in a different part of memory, so it might allocate your array here. And in this area of memory, even when the function that created it is destroyed and is no longer existing anymore, this variable will continue to exist as long as you tell it to be there. You have to explicitly tell it when you don't need that variable anymore. So this is great because instead of passing around a whole chunk of 5 integers, you can just pass around a pointer to this variable that continues to exist even outside of the function that created it. And another great thing about dynamic memory allocation is that you can resize arrays. So usually when you create an array, you have to specify a size as we do in these examples. However, you're committed to the size for the entire program. You can no longer change it. So if your nums really only need one integer, you'd be wasting a lot of space. Instead, with dynamic memory allocation, you can actually shrink that array if you need to. However, more often, you'll probably realize that you actually need more space than you decided at first. So what you can do with dynamic memory allocation is you can grow that array as much as you need to, as many times as you need. So that gives you a lot more flexibility in your programs. So just to recap, dynamic memory allocation is a process of managing memory during runtime. And the reason why it's important is because you can do things like create arrays of a size that the user gets to decide, and you can make variables that exist outside the function that created it, and you can resize arrays. So if you keep on watching to my next video, I'll walk you through the entire process of dynamic memory allocation using some diagrams to give you a better understanding.